Hello, hello, ChemEngPaul here, back again with the next part in this Let's Nostalgia play of Headhunter for the PS2. So, last time, we took on a somewhat hostage mission, rescue type thing, but it wasn't really, that wasn't our ultimate objective. We were trying to stop a bank raid, in essence. That went rather poorly. But to be honest, they're not even too bothered about the fact that all the hostages got massacred inside. What they're more worried about, obviously being as egocentric as they are, is the fact that they think that Jack here went and whacked one of the ACN guys themselves, which we obviously know to be complete bullshit. So someone is out to frame us, which we will have to find out who that is as we investigate this whole sordid affair. For the moment though, our immediate concerns is to work out, or to find out rather, what Ramirez was talking about when he was referring to Pentagon and Phoenix and Big Bang and all that sort of stuff. So to do that, we have to upgrade our license. So that's what we'll do now. And this is one of the ones where it starts to get awkward, because they give you a lot of checkpoints, but there's no specifically defined path to go about doing it. Apart from that one, obviously, that's the finish line. So I think we'll take some liberties with the shortcuts here. Oops. A minute and 1 second, that's not gonna happen. I wonder what's the best way to go about doing this. We should probably do. We'll do this, because obviously going in a straight line is faster than literally anything else on a motorbike. So the fewer turns that we have to make, the faster we should be. So if we do it this way and then. Here, whoosh, comes up. Do that one, and then we'll double back, and then it should just be a straight run to the final checkpoint. Gonna make this jump. Aye, awesome. And just in time. Excellent. Yeah, this is kind of the one where they like start taking the training wheels off a little bit. Everything is just, as you would expect, a little bit more difficult. But you can always just brute force your way through this stuff. Oops. I wonder if we set it off immediately. Whoops. There we go. Still works out. Oh, so I'll do that guy. Oh, come on. Get that guy to. This is gonna. Okay. Different plan. We'll start with this guy. Wow. It's super weird because there's like no lock on, because obviously you're just holding like decoy shells, so you can't actually lock in on the enemy. Yeah. Oh, why do you keep doing that? And it's super annoying because there's like literally no way to not equip decoy shells. You just have to. Awesome. Yeah, stealth just really isn't built for this kind of like input system. Like, if there was a lock on with all that stuff, not a problem. Use quick equip to switch between weapons. Or not. We might just end up using the pistol. Although wait, no, does this. Oh, is this the one? Aha, submachine gun. Excellent. Yeah, I think with more than 30 bullets, I probably just would have stuck with the machine gun there, but. This is cool. When in doubt. Hey, awesome. Cool, so again, records for everything as we're intending to go for. Pentagon personnel file. Thomas Gronig, codename Phoenix, armaments research. Yep. World Authority on Nuclear Fission. Ninety-three percent of all crime. Okay. What was that? Increased manpower and funding with priority for the biotech CCS implant. Okay. Interesting. And weapons will just be the submachine gun. Yeah, that's fine. Don't need to know that much more about it. So, don't know if that was really worth getting our A license for. Because we've just kind of figured out that it's oh, code breaker. That'll be useful. Never actually got to use that in the training. So yeah, the syndicate has something to do with a guy who knows something about nuclear fission, and they're putting more money into biotech.
Angela, get this. Phoenix is the code name of the military's top expert in nuclear fission.
Uh-oh.
Wu's teenage daughter went AWOL 2 months ago. Looks like the syndicate's got their claws into him.
Ramirez's big bang. That visit to Wolfpack HQ just got real urgent.
I'm on it.
Cool. So, none of that sounds good, but we'll see what that entails for us quite shortly. Now we're going to have to go back to Wolfpack, where we've been already. That's where we kicked Grey Wolf's arse. However, there was a couple of rooms, if you were like super observant, you might have noticed them in the corners of the room, but there was a couple of rooms that we couldn't quite get into before. And specifically, that one thing that had that magnetic lock on it, I am pretty sure that's what the code breaker is going to let us do. So it should save us having to run all the way through that area again. We should be able to just shortcut some of the stuff a wee bit. Or it might open up some entirely new things. I'm not entirely sure. So with that, we'll finish here with our new license, and we'll come back next time and we'll see what the Wolfpack HQ has in store for us. See you then.